Do you know that in a Shama'il al-Tirmidhi, which is the most authentic and the most famous book that describes the characteristics of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by Imam al-Tirmidhi. Tirmidhi has his famous Sunan. He also has a book called Shama'il. Shama'il, the characteristics of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has an entire chapter entitled The Chapter of the Jokes of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is in our most standard orthodox mainstream book about the characteristics of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In Sahih Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu said, write down my statements, write down the ahadith. And Abu Hurairah said, Ya Rasulullah, but sometimes you joke with us. Sometimes, innaka latumazihuna, you're joking with us, meaning do you want me to write down your jokes as well? And the Prophet ﷺ held on to his tongue and he said, Uktub, write down everything that comes. فَوَالَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ, I swear by the one that there is no God besides him. Nothing comes from here other than the truth. Meaning, even the jokes of the Prophet ﷺ have moral benefit, have wisdom. And today we'll discuss some of them and you will see each and every one of them actually has some wisdom, some benefit to it. Sometimes even theological benefit we learn from the jokes of Rasulullah ﷺ. But the point here, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu wanted to ask, O Messenger of Allah, you are joking with us so often. Do you want me to write those jokes down as well? What does that demonstrate? That it was the constant characteristic of Rasulullah ﷺ to be humorous, to be gentle. And that is because being gentle, being humorous is a part of the perfection of akhlaq. It is a part of being the perfect associate and companion. We all know there are those people amongst us, they're always morose, they're always frowning, they're always serious. We don't like being around them. Our Prophet was not like that. Our Prophet Muhammad was the best of the people, was the Sayyid of the children of Adam. And as a perfection, as Anas said, I never saw anybody smile more than the Prophet. He's always smiling. As a perfection, he would laugh. As his perfection, he would even be humorous and crack jokes. And all of this he did, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to legislate unto us that this too is a part and parcel of our religion of Islam. And so many of the humor of the Prophet is narrated. And typically, most of the humor, and if not all of it, our Prophet would use double meanings because he never said a lie. He never, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said a lie. So what were the humor? What was the humor of the Prophet? He'd use a phrase, he'd use a word. The meaning that comes to mind is not the meaning that is intended, but both meanings are permissible by the language. And there are so many instances of this. Or at times he would name somebody something as a point of being funny, or as a point of being humorous, or as a point of earning the heart of this person by using a gentle name, a sweet name, that a name that would make the person love the Prophet ﷺ. Anas ibn Malik, the young child, Anas ibn Malik was 7 years old when his mother said that I'm going to give you Anas all day long, he'll be your servant. So he gifted, Anas was not a slave, he gifted, the mother gifted the time of Anas, that throughout the day you'll be with the Prophet, come home at night to our house. So Anas would spend 10 years with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he tells us that at times he was a child, he's 7-8 years old, the Prophet would tell him to do something and he would be going on his way and children would be playing. So he'd stop to play and he wouldn't listen. So he would do what every child does. So the next time the Prophet ﷺ gave him a command, he said, Ya dhal udhunayn, O you of two ears, listen to what I'm about to say to you. He called Anas, O you of two ears, meaning you didn't listen to me last time, make sure you listen to me this time. Anas says that I had a younger brother who would have a pet of a bird. This bird in Arabic is called Nughair. It's a small little bird with red stripes on it. And this bird fell sick, so the child took it and took it as a pet. He took it as a pet and he would carry with it all the time. And this was a young boy of maybe 4 years old, 5 years old. One day the Prophet saw him crying in the corner. So he asked Anas, what is the matter with your brother? So he said his Nughair died. His little pet died, his little boy. And you know, typically this little boy is not addressed in the audience. I mean, the Prophet wouldn't say anything to him because, you know, he's a 4 or 5 year old boy. So in front of everybody, to make the boy feel so special, to make the boy feel as if he is being paid attention, in front of everybody, the Prophet addressed this little child and he invented for him a kunya. He made for him a kunya, which is not something you do for a 5 year old. That's what you do for an adult. But to make the boy feel special. And he said that famous phrase, which was reported in Bukhari, Ya Aba Umayr. مَا فَعَلَ النُّغَيْرُ. Oh, father of Umayr, this little boy is not the father of anybody. His name is Amr. Ya Aba Umayr, just be jokeful, get some humor. Ya Aba Umayr, what happened to your little bird? So here, it's not quite a joke per se, but it's being somewhat humorous. It's like lightening the moment so that this child feels consoled, so that the child feels this is Rasulullah addressing me in this big audience where Abu Bakr, Umar are sitting, and he's taking time out and smiling at me and saying, Ya Aba Umayr, ma fa'ala nughayr? Oh Abu Umayr, what happened to your little bird? In order to calm the child down. And it is also reported that in fact the Prophet actually said what we would call jokes. And the famous hadith is in Sahih Bukhari as well, and Abu Dawud, that a man came and he said, O Messenger of Allah, you called to go out on an expedition, I volunteer. I'm going to join the expedition and I will go with this force, but I don't have any camel. So you will have to give me a camel to ride on. Now, in Arabic, a baby camel is literally called waladun naqa, baby camel. When you want to say a baby camel, there's no word baby. You say waladun naqa. So the Prophet ﷺ said, I don't have anything to give you other than waladun naqa. Waladun naqa, the child of a camel. And the man said, O Messenger of Allah, what will a baby camel do for me? Because what you understand from waladun naqa is a baby. And the Prophet ﷺ said, wasn't every camel born by the previous camel? Isn't every child waladun naqa? So waladun naqa, linguistically it means that the offspring of a camel. But it's understood to mean the baby of a camel. So when the Prophet ﷺ said, I only have a baby camel, waladun naqa, he understood a little camel. And the Prophet ﷺ then joked with him, said, and what is a camel except the child of another camel? Isn't every child waladun naqa? Isn't every camel waladun naqa? And of course, there's the very famous story that we've all heard of growing up. And it is an authentic hadith. It's an authentic hadith that when the Prophet ﷺ was sitting with the Sahaba, an old lady hobbles up and she says, Ya Rasulullah, make dua that Allah causes me to enter Jannah. Make dua that Allah causes me to enter Jannah. And you know, you see this sweet old lady, you see this lady, you know she has such a sweetheart, whatnot. So the Prophet ﷺ wanted to cheer her up. How did he cheer her up? By saying something that was true and yet humorous. It was true and yet it was a joke. He says, Oh mother, oh aunt, oh lady, oh fulan, haven't you heard? Old ladies will not enter Jannah. Haven't you heard? Didn't somebody teach you this? Old ladies shall not enter Jannah. So the hadith says, Fawal walat. You know, she started like raising her voice. What? What's going to happen now? How am I going to enter Jannah? And so the Prophet ﷺ said, didn't you read what Allah says in the Quran? Inna ansha'nahunna insha'a faja'alnahunna abkaran uruban atraba. We shall bring them back and recreate them. Inna sha'nahunna insha'a. And we will bring them back to be young, beautiful maidens. Oh fulana, oh ummi fulana. Allah Azza wa Jal will not cause you to enter Jannah as an old lady. You will come back to being at the prime of your youth, at the most youthful, the most beautiful. Then Allah will cause you to enter Jannah. Now, imagine if the Prophet ﷺ didn't say this humorous. He just went straight to the point. You will enter Jannah. It's not as good. It's not as uplifting. Even she, the happiness she would feel after the joke, is much more than if the Prophet ﷺ simply said that you shall enter Jannah. Rather than saying you're going to enter Jannah, he actually was humorous with her. And she said, old ladies don't enter Jannah. And then gave her the good news, you shall enter Jannah as a beautiful young lady, as you were. That's how you're going to enter Jannah. So this actually hadith demonstrates for us the purpose of the humor of the Prophet ﷺ. That it is meant to make a point, to uplift the cheerful spirit, to make people feel better. And this is a part and parcel of our religion, that we're supposed to cheer people up. We're supposed to uplift the spirits. And at times, the best way to do that is through humor. It is narrated that A woman came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said, "Who is your husband?" She said, "So and so." And the Prophet wanted to, basically what we would call play a joke, but we say that he wanted to be humorous with the husband. So he said, "Oh, I know your husband. He is the one who has a whiteness in his eye." Now the Arabic whiteness in his eye means a disease that causes the eye to go yellowish, okay? And the Arabs say bayad fil ayn. This is something to do with a sickness, right? And the lady became shocked. "No, that's not my husband. That's not the one. My husband's fine." And the Prophet said, no, I'm positive. He is the one that has the sickness, bayad fi ayn. She understood sickness, but it's not sickness. So she went back home because she thinks if the Prophet says this, he must be sick. And she began looking at her husband carefully, staring into his eyes. And the husband says, "What's the matter with you? Why are you looking at me like this?" So she said, "The Prophet said that you have a sickness, bayad fi ayni. You have a sickness in your eye." And the husband understood, because obviously he understands what's going on. They have that relationship together. And he said, "Ya Ummi Fulana, don't you see there's more whiteness in my eye than darkness," right? Meaning in his eyes, there's a whiteness, the whiteness of the eye. That's what the Prophet is talking about. Once again, there is the feeling. Now imagine how special the husband would feel. Imagine that unique bond that the husband will feel, that the Prophet is making me laugh in this manner. This is the purpose of Islamic humor. This is why we are supposed to be gentle. We're supposed to be easygoing. We're supposed to bring happiness unto others. And the companions as well, in fact, would return back the humor to the Prophet when it was appropriate to do so, in the most appropriate manner. When they understood that the Prophet is joking with them, at times they would be humorous back. Ultimate respect even in the humor. Hadith narrated that the Prophet visited Suhaib al-Rumi, the Roman. He was the Roman convert to Islam, Suhaib al-Rumi. And Suhaib was very sick and he was not coming to the masjid, and so we expected him to be on his bed completely moaning and groaning. When they came in, they found that he's sitting upright and he's eating dates. But his sickness was there, one of his eyes was swollen. So the Prophet ﷺ joked with him and said, "You are sick. Your eyes are swollen and yet here you are eating dates." Meaning, we have heard you're so sick, but now you're enjoying life, right? So he's being humorous. And you could see by the expression that the Prophet is being humorous. And he said, "Your eye is swollen up and you're still eating dates." So he said, "O Messenger of Allah, I'm using my other eye to eat. I'm looking at the other eye, I'm using this eye as I pick the dates up to eat." Now this is, again, imagine being Suhaib. Just imagine the feeling, the relationship with the Prophet ﷺ, right? That he's cracking a joke at with me. And he's then responding back, "Ya Rasulullah, it's the other, I'm using this one. This one's swollen, I can still see with this one. That's what I'm eating with." And so again, the point being, all of this demonstrates that it is a part and parcel of our religion to bring this happiness unto others. In fact, it's not just words. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam even went beyond just words. Humor at times involves playing around with other people. At times involves literally using your hands or doing things. And we have one of the interesting narrations here as well, that our Prophet would play and basically be jovial with the little children. Now we know this, of course, from many a hadith, that he was the kindest to children. One of the companions who died, the very last of the companions, or one of the last, so he died around 100 Hijrah. Imagine 100 Hijrah, right? He says, and he of course saw the Prophet as a little child. He says, "I still remember when the Prophet ﷺ came to our house and to our neighborhood, that he played with me and he threw some water from the glass that he had into my face. That he sprinkled some water onto my face." Now this is like, you know, you're teasing little children, you're just playing with them. So the child now becomes a Sahabi, he's now 90 years old, actually he was 100 or something when he passed away. Says, "I still remember the Prophet ﷺ coming and playing with me and throwing water from the mug onto my face." So again, this is like teasing the child, running around with the child. So the fact the Prophet ﷺ is even being what we would call basically playful with the children. And this is again well reported.